Yeah. The goggles that I got for them. They love the good bobbing wave. There they got those goggles that I gave them. I just threw them in the water. Nicole's getting ready to mount up. She says, I got to check things out. Gee, I got to know what's going on under that H2O. And so does Boo Boo. Well, they look like they're having fun. I know I am. I love these water parks in the summer, even when the sun's not out. And that's what they're in, the old bobbing wave at Blizzard Beach. Not as good as the surfing wave at Typhoon Lagoon, but it's better than nothing. Now I got out here where I got a little better angle at those two turkeys. They're saying, okay, G, you make the memories, suffer with the heat, we're staying cool. Can't say that I blame them. Nice cool water. Now let's see if I can find the girls. Well, I don't see them right now, but they're out there somewhere in that mass of humanity. And I'm going to be back in it pretty soon myself. I'm picking up good bobbers. No, I shouldn't be singing that. I should be singing Jingle Bells or something like that. Well, this is it. The girls, their annual passes expires in 2 days, so we've been getting them to the parks as much as we can. Well, I should say me, I've been getting them to the parks as much as I can. Don't see the girls anywhere. Hey, looks like the Turks found themselves a tube finally. So they can ride those bobbing waves. Nicole, what do you need your goggles on for now, girl? Unless you're planning on falling off of that thing. Uh-oh, there they go. Somebody went.
Monica!
Yep, looks like Nicole fell off. Well, I think it's time for me to go put the camera away and get back in the water. What do you out there in the viewing audience think?
You got it, G. Time for you to get back out in the, get back into the H2O. Cool off a little bit.
That's the way I see it. Thank you. two kids having mucho fun. All right, time to take this puppy back now. All right, would you like to tell me your observation? What was it that you just came up with?
A picnic in the park is better than a picnic in the parking lot.
A picnic in the park is better than a picnic in the parking lot? I agree. And what do you say there, girl? Do you agree too? Mm-hmm. Yep, as she stuffs her face. What are you girls gonna do next?
Lazy River.
Oh, okay. Well, I just came out of it, but I only did half of it, so I'll go back in with you. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's great.
Well, you've got to try your sandwich.
I'm going to eat my sandwich right now. What do you say, girl? What sayeth you, boo-boo? Huh? Man, the vacuum cleaner. She's not breathing once again. Medical science is completely baffled at how that girl can do it. Am I right?
Yes.
Now it's time to eat. I'm not sure if I was recording. I sure hope I was. Boo Boo, what's wrong?
Nothing.
And there's the sandwich that Nicole wants me to tie into. Do you like this secluded spot, Nicole? I do too. That's what I'm talking about. We have some people back here, but it's really pretty quiet. And look at those woods that we have behind us. That's the kind of stuff that Nicole loves. She said, good job, G. I wanted to set up where all the people were, and G said, no, we gotta come back into the vegetation. Now you'll notice that Boo Boo has a bathing suit on, but it's not the one she started out in because the one that she started out in, the strap broke. I asked her, I said, Boo Boo, why did you bring a second bathing suit? And what did you tell me? No, what did you say? You're always what?
I'm always bringing extra.
Turn around, look at me. You said, I'm always what?
Bringing extra.
Now, what did you tell me when I asked you why you brought two bathing suits?
I'm always prepared.
That's exactly what you said. And today, that chick needed it, didn't you? And when you go to the beach, you take 5 sets of underwear?
No.
Huh?
Well, she brings like 4 tops. 3 pairs.
All right, Nicole, honey, tell me, how many pair of underwear?
5.
5. How many pairs of tops?
4.
And what? How many boxes of Depends?
Mm-mm. I don't know. She brings too many. I can't count.
Too many, because she gets scared, doesn't she? And then she fills them. Oh, Boo Boo. Boo Boo is moisturizing herself with grape juice. Is that gonna do a good job on your skin, girl? Huh? Well, look at me. Tell me about it. Now she's gonna moisturize Nicole with the grape. Uh-oh. I see a battle starting. Hey, don't waste those grapes. I need some. Yeah, Boo Boo said, when we started out, I don't think this is gonna be too good a day. I said, it's not going to rain at all. Who was right? Well, it's 2:00 in the afternoon. And look at that sunshine. I really like it back here in this nature area. What do I got? Where? Show them to me. Where? Ooh, hand those puppies to me. You got it. Thank you. What's wrong? What's wrong, Boo Boo? Hey, what's wrong? I mean, we are at Blizzard Beach after all, aren't we?
Yes.
Huh? You never know when it's going to snow or have an ice storm. Did you have an ice storm in your bottoms?
Yes.
Yes, you did, didn't you, girl? Was it a little chilly?
Yes.
Huh? Was it a little chilly?
No,
Oh, I can see Boo Boo wants to retaliate. But will she? Will she be able to? That is the big question. And looks like the answer is no.
We need a toast.
Okay, now here we are. Yes, I have all kinds of video.
Wow, I'm impressed.
It's David's, this is David's last hurrah at Epcot before he... I'm the only one that'll see this besides you.
So you know what his real name is.
We're gonna go to, I don't know where we're gonna go, but David leaves for PA on Monday for his new job.
There are certain things below the Arctic Hemisphere that you don't know.
Come on, keep talking. What do you have to say to me?
I'm gonna miss this guy.
Yeah, so am I.
Not me. Whatever. I could care less.
Make sure you could not care.
Start caring.
You're saying you could not care less.
I didn't hear what I just said. I said make sure you turn that off before I start caring. I meant crying.
Yes, but when you say that, you mean I could not care less.
I think I said I couldn't. I could
you
care.
Said you said I could care less.
I could care less.
Yeah, but what
is? Correct, also though.
Yeah, but you could care less, and that means that you could care even more or less, but. But what you mean is I could not care less
about your diatribe.
That's right. Okay, let's get out of here and do something.
Can you please become an officer so I can put pictures up on Facebook? I mean, this is very important to me.
Boots, why is your shirt so wet? Is that sweat or did you spill a beer?
No, I pour water on myself and tell them I spilled a beer and then they give me free beer.
Ah, okay. Misha, what do you think of that subterfuge, huh?
I think I've spent a whole lot less than she has.
Do you condone it? You say it's sheer genius?
I think it's sheer genius. Do I have the guts to do it? No.
Well, you should have seen some of the things. Hey, get in here, son.
You should have seen the last lady. She's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Do you want to go inside and get dried off? I'm like, no, it's hot out. I just care about my beer. And then we were taking pictures by the donkey. I actually did spill my beer, and I thought I was going to cry. But he got another free one, so it was okay.
Well, that's good. Hey, listen, U2 concert right behind us. Let's go for it.
All right, I need to get another beer.
What happened, honey?
I spilled my beer all over me. I think I need a new one. I'm gonna go get one.
You spilled it all over you, huh?
I did.
Right
did
out.
You see the beautiful water feature behind me?
Right out of that fountain, she spilled her beer.
Oh my God.
Well, you better go get. Somebody actually knocked it out of your hand.
No, I know how to do this. Trust me, I'm a friggin' pro.
All right, go for it. the concert? Sure am, Dad. Loves a good concert. Boy loved every second of the concert. He loved every second of the concert. But he's got some nose problems. He needs a shave too. And then there's Misha. She's the one that told us to do all of that stuff. The instigator. She's the instigator. You did it?
Guys, the point was I could take pictures.
I have a very good talent of putting inanimate objects in people's orifices.
Well, I'll tell you what, you did a fine job. Of course, I think Boots had a little something to do with
it. Guys, point left. The picture is priceless.
Okay, well, I got to save the rest of this DVD for the parade.
How's it going? Right, you're adorable. Charles.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Magic Kingdom proudly presents our spectacular festival pageant of nighttime magic and imagination. In thousands of sparkling lights and electro-symphonic musical sounds, the Main Street Electrical Parade.
met, what the heck's the name of this place? Not Pollyanna. Tobyhanna State Park. I've been here all day. It's around, oh, probably 4 in the afternoon. Well, I haven't been here all day, but I've been here for at least 4 hours or so. And I've been taking all kinds of still pictures, and I decided I would just, since I have this new type of DVD, I decided I'd try just a little bit of recording here at the old Tobyhanna State Park, just so I can play it back and see if I get full screen display. Okay, that's good enough. See you later. Well, playback looked pretty good. I'll video a little more. They have some great trails along here. No cliffs or high rocks or anything like that. This is built around the lake, so it's all pretty level, but it's kind of nice. Yeah, the whole time I've been here, I've been hoping to see... Uh-oh, hang on. Sorry about that. I had a bug on my leg. The whole time I've been here, I've been hoping to see a deer and praying that I don't see any bear. Well, I haven't seen any deer. Get out of there, bug. And I haven't seen any bear. What do you think? I'd say that I'm pretty deep in the woods, wouldn't you? I'll tell you what. Hey, the sun is back out. It's been one of those days where it's been cloudy and sunny, off and on, no rain. A little humid, but the temperature's got to be in the low 80s. I've been perspiring, but not that much, and you guys know what a sweat hog I am. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Oh, I forgot. I've been on the Blue Trail all day long. And it's, as you can see, very easy to keep track of the Blue Trail. Because they have blue marks painted on the trees all over the place. I have to admit, I am sweating a bit. And loving every second of it. Wow, that's the brightest the sun has been all day. I said it was going in and out, but it's really bright now. I'm coming up to the lake, and in a little bit I'm going to be heading to the Tobyhanna, the little city of Tobyhanna. But I'll show you a little bit more of this park before I'm done with videoing today. You should see the still pics I got. There was about 50 or 60 high school kids coming through cross country. I got all kinds of still pics. I wish I would have thought to get the camera out and video them running. They had some of them had pretty good form. A couple of the girls were real cute too. Hunting, shooting, trapping, and dog training prohibited. I finally got back into the safe zone. I was hiking a trail where they allowed hunting, but I don't think there's any hunting going on right now. I certainly hope not. Well, the kids came from there running, so I assumed it was safe. Dang, an Amish picnic table right here in the middle of Tobyhanna State Park. That is sad. Now here's the trail that takes me down to the lake. I'll show you the lake in just a second. Yep, this is it. I don't know what lake it is, but if I was a guessing man, I'd guess Lake Tobyhanna. There's been a lot of people here today, but when I say a lot, I'm talking hundreds, and they've been spaced out. There have been stretches of time today when I've been totally by myself for 15, 20, 25, 30 minutes the way G loves it. You know it. All right, time to get back on the trail. I said trail, not tail. I'm here by myself. But I'd well admit that this would be a great place to hike with a chick you had the hots on. And who had the hots back on you. But those days are over. Okay, I'm going to try doing something I've never done before, and that's video myself. I just came off of the trail. You can see somebody wants to be sporting some wood. They've really piled it up, and... I don't know what that's all about. In a little bit, I'll show you some more. I got to turn this off and check it out and see if I've got it working correctly. Hang on one second. Actually, that came out pretty good. Now, right behind me, that's the trail that I just came off of. And I was actually down part of it where it said they could actually hunt, but I didn't think there was anything going on. And in just a second, I'm going to show you the dam that I've was on earlier. But this is G doing his thing at Tobyhanna. I got to pronounce that right, like Hannah Montana. Tobyhanna State Park. Now this little path behind me right here leads to the dam, and that's where I'm going. That's not G Dam, that's the dam where the lake was formed. So we'll be back. I'll take you over there in a second and you can see it. Some of the things that I've been doing all day long. Hope everybody in the view of the audience loves this tape because it's tough on me to do it, but I'll do anything for the video. Yeah, the gateway down from the parking lot. I'm still on the path over to the dam. I forgot to tell you, this is David's second day at work, and he's already in the overtime mode. It should be around 4:35 o'clock, which means he's already picked up 2 hours of overtime. That's $84. Rake it in, son. Do it while you're young, tuck it away, and have a good life. Kudos and plaudits to you. I know you're all saying, gee, how could David's car be sitting in the Tobyhanna State Park parking lot? I thought he left it down in Florida. Well, just for memory's sake, Sunday, a couple of days ago, G put on a 17 and a half, 18 hour marathon drive all by himself and brought David his car. Okay, now there's the dam I was talking about. We got some breeze behind me, so I may have wind noise in the microphone, I don't know. But anyway, this is the dam that formed the lake that the state park was built around. And all around this lake are hiking trails, camping areas, picnic areas, a few brothels. Mickey's Quickies tried to get in here, but there was no room. Eisner was pissed. That's when he was CEO. But anyway, this is it. Of course, we got the old country highway deep in the Pocono Mountains of Pennsylvania. As I said, there have been people here today. I'm not out here by myself. And 423, that road is a heavily traveled highway. About 5 or 6 miles straight down, it dead ends into 196. You can turn right and that'll take you into 611. Supposedly, and that's the way I went to get to the casino, but I never could find that casino that David told me about. Never could find it. I know what you're thinking. Did you stop and ask anybody, G? Well, yes, I did. I stopped and asked a young lady in her late 20s, early 30s, and the way she was talking sounded like she would have liked to have gone with me. But anyway, she gave me instructions. I had already passed the place, turned around and went back, and still couldn't find it. Well, obviously, this waterfall is nothing like the gorge in Cuyahoga Falls, but it gets the job done. It creates a little lake that's probably, I'm going to guess, not a whole lot more than 20, 30 feet deep. But it's pretty big, I'll tell you what. In a little while, I'll get David, then you'll see him on this video. And we're going to go probably back to a troop and gets and eat at the Roadhouse, Texas Roadhouse. Just wanted to prove I was really here. Yep, even yet more country road. This road actually goes through the park. Yes, I'm driving around now. I hiked this earlier today. That's why I know where everything is. No, that's not a dam, that's a bridge. In fact, you can see, it's the bridge I just came over. Yeah, I think this is rapidly becoming David's favorite wetland in all of Pennsylvania. I'm pretty sure he'll be over here one of these days to see what it's all about. Well, I hope he does anyway. He said he can't wait to get over to Tobyhanna State Park. It's been nice. And all the way across the lake, that's the beach. I think there are some people out there. Sure looks like it. Well, that's about it for me at Toby Hanna Park today. I'm going to go get some cigarettes at the grocery store, at this gas station, put $10 worth of gas in David's tank because I've been driving his car up one side and down the other. And then I'm going to go find myself a place to just sit and rest until David gets done working. It's 5 o'clock. He's already picked up 2 hours OT. And hopefully he's ready to shut it down pretty soon. I think he said around 6 o'clock. So I'm in pretty good shape because it's 5 right now. I've had a great day today. Notice, access after sunset limited to boating and fishing only. Violators will be prosecuted. I couldn't read that word. I was trying to come up with procreated, but I choked. Eh, there goes the joke. But it was supposed to be violators will be procreated, but I couldn't remember the stinking word whenever I was reading that off. Gee, you suck.
I know it.
Yes, David's favorite hotel in Toby Hanna, Kubler's Mountain Hotel. He said it was one of the best stays he ever had anywhere. Kubler's Mountain Hotel. The boy's home for 1 week until I got his car up to him. Now he's living in Troop. And he said he absolutely loved this old church. Almost made him want to start going on Sundays. You know, I have to admit the landscaping on that church isn't half bad. And that looks like it's a pretty old building, but it's probably well maintained. Later, I'm out of here.
See you later, Mary. Your pussy's kind of hairy.
Well, I'm sitting here in the park and I thought you'd like to know that David, I just talked to him and he's going to work till 6:30. So on day two, he works from 7:30 to 6:30. Check this out. For that long a time, he gets 4 half-hour breaks and he gets paid for all of it. The dude actually got paid for 11 hours today, 3 of which were overtime at $42 an hour. I'll tell you what, that guy has, he's really latched on to one whale of a job, and I'm kind of envious. Well, I can't be envious. When I was young like that, I was making that kind of coin too. But anyway, sounds like the boy's going to do pretty doggone good. So I'm supposed to meet him over at Keebler's Cookies, whatever the heck that thing is, at 7 o'clock. And it's, it's a little after 6 right now, so it won't be too long before I hook up with him. Tomorrow, if I can, I'm going to try to drop him off early around 7 o'clock and then go all the way down to Gettysburg and Valley Forge, which is about a 2.5-hour drive. So that 2.5 hours down, 2.5 hours back, that means that I'd have around 5 hours or 6 hours to go through those Gettysburg and Valley Forge. So we're going to see if we can work that out. Okay, that's it for today. See you later. Hey, I have a couple of minutes to kill. I thought I'd stop by and take a little video here of Toby Hanna International Train Station. This is one of the busiest train depots I've ever seen. Right now they're in a lull. And what's really cool about it is that to make it convenient for the founding fathers and the city officials, they built the town hall for Toby Hanna right across the street from the International Depot. Right there is Toby Hanna. I knew I was going to do that. Toby Hanna's town hall. Okay, the courthouse is in the back, and they have all kinds of record keeping. You can go there for divorce or get everything done rather quickly here in Toby Hanna. And anyway, that's it. How do I know this is the International Train Depot? I'll show you in a moment. Well, that proves it right there. That engine is just ready and raring to go here at Toby Hanna International Train Depot, or depot, whichever you prefer. Home Depot? I guess it's a depot. And look at that sorry track. It goes all the way to the end. Okay, that's it. Now you guys really know Toby Hanna. Inside and out. Okay, here I am at Gettysburg at my first battlefield. Army of the Potomac 11 Corps, 2nd Division. And let's see what that says. Brigadier General Adolf von Steinwehr. This was the Battle of Cemetery Hill, and I'm going to show you that in just a second. I'll show you that in just a second. Okay, long story short, Union soldiers held Cemetery Hill, and they were attacked by the South, the Rebs, and I'll have to read this and see who won. The Union won. They got reinforcements and swept the Rebels back. Now let's take a look at the battle site. Okay, this is the hill we're on top of. This is Cemetery Hill. We're looking down over the side. There's memorials everywhere that I'm going to go check out. And then hopefully I can find some other battlegrounds. I'm going to the cemetery across the street too. I haven't even been to the visitor center yet. Yep, top of Cemetery Hill. I forget what it was. I think Cemetery Hill. Anyway, this was the battle site. It is a hill. You won't be able to tell it that much from the video, but it's pretty cool. That's where Washington stopped and had Gatorade whenever the battle was getting too hot for him. He'd rest underneath that tree. Oh, wait a minute. That's the Revolutionary War, not the Civil War. Sorry about that. Ah, I get confused with my history. I guess that's where they had their cannons mounted, at the top of the hill. Then some big dog up there on his horse. And right across the street is the cemetery that I'm going to be going to visit some graves. Yep, here I am in wonderful downtown Gettysburg, where the huge Battle of Gettysburg took place in 1775. Maybe it was 1776, I don't know. As we all know, the Union won that war. And they won the Battle for Gettysburg, too. Now that's a trail down. You know, I think I'm going to walk down there because there seems to be some activity. There may be more battlegrounds off to the left. I'll show you what I speak. You see that monument down there? That little walkway. I'm going to go check it out. Hey, I was just talking to a local and he said this stone wall was constructed during the Civil War. It was used for protection from cannon fodder. That's not the same big dog, that's another big dog. Now what I'm going to do in a little bit is go around and get close up to these statues and find out what they commemorate. I'm halfway down the hill right now, as you may be able to tell. My video is going uphill. Cemetery Hill. You know, that wasn't such a good idea because now I have to climb back up that hill. This is a monument to the 54th Regiment New York Infantry, Hiram Barney Rifles. I don't know if that's from Hiram, Ohio or not. 1st Brigade, 1st Division, something Corps. No, not Apple Corps. You go. Okay, that's the walkway I'm going to be going down directly behind me. As you can see, off to my left shoulder, some serious woods. Now, I don't know how tall those trees were during the Civil War, but there's a good chance that some of those suckers probably were alive then. It's fun to think about anyway. Okay, let's go see what else we can find out down here at old Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Okay, here we have a young lady come walking through. Not walking through, running through. Make it hurt. No pain, no gain. She didn't look too happy that I was videoing her, but I don't really care. If she's in my shot, she's in my shot. This 16:9 looks like it might be for widescreen. I did 4:3 aspect ratio on the first side. This 16:9 looks like it might be for widescreen. So we'll see. I think I wanted to do 4:3. I got a different kind of DVD and I don't really like it. Yep, looking back up to the top of Cemetery Hill. I'll tell you what, this is the first time I've been really warm since I got to Pennsylvania. I am down out of the mountains in southern PA, and it's much warmer down here than it is up in the mountains. Okay, this memorial was erected, it was put here by the state of Connecticut to honor their fallen in the Civil War. Let's look at the front of it. The old 17th Connecticut Volunteers. Now this is just to the right of Cemetery Hill. I think probably where battles were fought also, because I don't think it was just contained in that one small area. That's all Cemetery Hill, but now as you can see, it's quite nice residential sections. Real nice, as a matter of fact. Well, it's time for me to go back up to the top of the hill and then over to the graveyard, and then I'm pimping down to the visitor center. I know what you're all thinking out there in the audience. You go, Big G. Oh yes, the local high school at the bottom of Cemetery Hill. The chicks are out there doing their pom-poms for football season. Now is the time. Yeah, that's really a nice area. I really like it. They have a hiking and jogger trail there. Oh, there goes a chick now. Yep, they've done it up pretty nice right in this area. Okay, let's go see what else we have going down here. Now this memorial right here was erected by the state of Ohio. It's a memorial from the state of Ohio. Oh, hey, in the year 2525, if God is coming and we're still alive, that just brought on a song. Or no, was it in the year 7510, if God is coming, he ought to make it by then. Oh, well, I better stop singing because I'm going to put everybody to sleep. Well, I'm almost back up to the top of Cemetery Hill. I see it was fortified with cannons. And now I'm going to go up and read the plaque and really find out how the battle turned out. I know the North won, but I'm not quite sure how they did it. Then I'll let everybody in the view in the audience, sorry about that wiggle, who's been waiting with breathless anticipation, I'll let you know how the North won the battle. I think it was because they brought in reinforcements, so I think that's what I read. Okay, it says the Confederate attack towards this position. So that means that they were coming up the hill. The cemetery archway ahead is shown behind the guns in this wartime engraving. And believe it or not, that archway still exists, and I'm about to show it to you. Right there it is, across the street. The archway entrance to Cemetery Hill, and I'm going to go over there and see what's going on over there in a second, and then, like I said, I'm heading out to the visitor station to find out where all the places are that I want to see. Yeah, man, I am standing in the middle of some serious history. Serious history. Okay, here I am in Evergreen Cemetery, and this place has Civil War history too, which I'm about to show you and read you. Army of the Potomac Artillery Reserve, 2nd Volunteer Brigade, 5th New York Light Artillery, 620 Pounder Parrots, Captain Elijah D. Taft. And they arrived and walked in the park at about 10 a.m. That was on July 2nd, I'm not sure what year. But anyway, they were here fighting. Casualties of the battery killed one man, wounded two men. Engaged at intervals in same position until 4 p.m. when blah, blah, blah. Well, anyway, they definitely were fighting here where this cemetery is located now. I don't believe during the Civil War, or was it in 1800? No, 17. I don't believe in the Civil War that this was a cemetery. That archway was built, but it's a cemetery now. I didn't notice this before. The hill part that I've been videoing from, which you saw the shots go out over, is East Cemetery Hill. I mean, the shots over the hill. East Cemetery Hill. As you can see, it is hot and sunny here in old Gettysburg today. Well, I'm heading to the visitor center. Man, I just saw a sign out front on another entrance that I just came through. This is a national cemetery. That's a memorial to some soldier that was that fought in the war. I'm gonna go see if I can get his name. Major General John Reynolds. This looks a little bit like Arlington Memorial in Washington. These are graves of soldiers that died in the Civil War. Yeah, I know I said I was going to go down to the visitor center, but I saw this second entrance and I was intrigued, and so I came in to check it out, and I'm glad I did. Wow, there are a lot of graves in the rows there for the Civil War deceased. Looks like it, no, it doesn't look like it is. There's a tour group going through. I didn't even know they had guided tours. I'm all the way at the back of the cemetery now. It's pretty peaceful and quiet back here. Well, actually, what you're looking at now, as best I can tell, is the west side of Cemetery Hill. I'm going to go over the edge and see if that drops down. Hall's Battery, 2nd Maine, July 2nd, 1863. And yes, it does go downhill. I'll show you. This is the west side of Cemetery Hill. First, I better show you some of Hall's Battery. Now, I don't know if these are recreations or if they are rehabbed original equipment, but these are sitting around that Hall's Battery that I just showed you. And down the hill, ever so gently. It's not a real big hill, but it's a hill nonetheless. Don't argue with me. I know a hill when I see one. Especially if it's on a woman's chest. See, I'm not the only one in the cemetery. Little tribute to Abe. I'm up close so that I don't get glare on the lens. All right, time to blow this popcorn stand. I gotta believe, although I'm not a horticulturist or a botanist, I don't know for sure, but I gotta believe that those trees were around during the Civil War, as big and old as they look. I mean, look at the size of those trunks. Those things had to be around for a long, long time.